the news of the day and what surprised a lot of people in the hockey world this morning was the Capitals placing Devontae Smith-Pelly on waivers. He was a major factor during the Stanley Cup playoffs for the Caps last season, scored 7 goals in the postseason for Washington en route to, of course, winning the Stanley Cup. He is now on waivers. For more on this, we bring in NHL Network insider Elliotte Friedman. Elliotte, what's behind this move? Is there something looming, something in the works here for the Caps?
I do. I believe so. I believe they're working on a deal with possibly involving Carl Hagelin from the LA Kings. He seems to be the name that we're hearing a lot of right now. And obviously that can't happen until things get done tomorrow in terms of does Smith-Pelly clear waivers or what the Capitals have to do to make part of it. But there's a lot of smoke around a Capitals-Kings deal. And Hagelin is the name I'm hearing the most. And he's obviously a guy who's had a lot of success in the Eastern Conference as a member of both the Rangers and a Stanley Cup champion with the Penguins. It would be interesting to see him back here.
I want to follow up, Elliotte, because Devontae Smith-Pelly, I mean, he was a big part of things for this team in the playoffs last year and in the final in particular, but all throughout the playoffs. He took less, it seemed like, to stay with the Washington Capitals. It seems like now, only several months later, he's already expendable. I mean, does that send a message to anybody in that organization? Or maybe is that what they're trying to do, send a message?
You know, EJ, you've been around hockey for a long time. You know sports can be a really tough business. And you have to make difficult decisions and decisions that affect the lives of people.
Yeah.
And I was at the Capitals practice today in Toronto where this happened. And two really good reporters, Chris Cook and Isabel Hrdushin, had reported that Jaskin was going on waivers beforehand, and it changed while the practice was on. And so he gets off the ice, and I saw him come out of the dressing room after getting dressed, and you could tell he was really mad. And some of his teammates were around him trying to help him, make him feel better, just figure out what was going on. I saw Oshie there. I believe that Michael Kempney was there. And, you know, the Capitals are in Toronto today. They're playing here tomorrow night. They're donating a ring to one of their rings to the Hockey Hall of Fame. And they had a team lunch after their practice today. And I was driving out after, and I just saw Smith-Pelly just outside waiting by the bus. It's, you know, sports is a great thing, but sports can be a very, very tough business. And we were all reminded of that today. And, you know, his teammates feel terribly for him. They're going to rally around him, and we'll just have to see what happens tomorrow. As you mentioned, he took a bit less money to stay, but that less money could put him in a very good situation tomorrow. I would be surprised if there aren't some teams tonight who are looking for help in the playoffs who aren't saying we could do a hell of a lot worse than Devontae Smith-Pelly.
Elliotte, you know, given the Ottawa Senators' rankings in the Eastern Conference standing, apt to part with some assets, any update on Mark Stone, if he's leaving? If he's leaving, where's he going?
You know, Stu, I think we're going to know about Stone in the next 24 to 48 hours. I mean, what's interesting is Duchesne, the Senators, just finished their skate today, and I'm seeing some of the quotes from the reporters, and they asked Duchesne about not playing tomorrow night. And he said, well, I don't know anything about that, basically, and I'm preparing as if I'm playing. Now, I do expect Ottawa to hold him out. And as I said earlier this week on one of the shows here, I believe that Nashville is the team that is working the hardest to see not only about acquiring Duchesne, but also about possibly extending him. So I think that's in the works. I don't know if it will happen, but I think that's what Nashville's trying to do, and we'll see tomorrow night. I think with Stone, I think Ottawa made him an offer last week. I think it was not max term, but I think it was good money. I heard one of the rumors I heard last week was 5 years at $10.5 million. Now, a couple people disputed that, but a couple others came back and said, you know what, that might not be too far off from the truth. So they've at least made Mark Stone think. And I think we'll know in the next 24 to 48 hours what his situation is.
Man, lots buzzing around the NHL with the trade deadline looming. One more for you, Elliotte. There are reports saying that the Ducks are closing in on an extension with Silfverberg. What can you tell us about that?
I believe that is true. I heard the issue was never, well, I shouldn't say never. I heard the issue not recently. Recently was not money. I think they had both kind of agreed on what the salary would be. I think the question was, what was the term going to be? I think the team wanted around 4 years.
The player was hoping for 5 or 6. So I assume this is going to be a 5 or 6 year deal, and that will close it out. But, you know, we've talked about this a couple of times. There's something in the NHL called tagging. This year, the salary cap is $79.5 million. You cannot have commitments for salaries in future seasons over what is the salary cap this year. So Anaheim cannot have anything over $79.5 million total next year. They're close. They're okay. In a situation where this might have to wait, and until that gets sorted out, but I do think the extension is going to get done now that both sides are kind of agreeing on term.
All right, well, considering today's news, the next 24 hours should be very interesting. Elliot, thank you for this.
Look forward to making up plenty more, yes.